sometimes extraordinary things happen to you out of nowhere. And about 15 years ago, a very dear friend of mine named Luana Anders introduced me to a friend of hers named Richard Martini. And at that time, I was out in Los Angeles making movies, and every night at my house, different people would come over, Luana and Rhea Napus, who later married my agent, Jim Berkus, and two or three or four people would sit around. It was a very closed group, and I basically would do this show, except we weren't being televised. And we'd have these three, four people as guests, and it was great. I mean, every single night, I would do the show like I do now. No cameras, no makeup, nothing, you know. And we had a great time. And so when I, you know, came to do this show, they said, "If you have any experience," I said, "Yeah, I've been doing this for like 20 years, except, you know, I haven't been televised, but, you know, no problem." Anyway, Luana introduced me to Richard Martini, and everybody who knew me knew that nobody really got into my house. I mean, I had to know you, know your parents, grandparents. You had to have blood tests, you know, and you had tetanus shot and everything to get to my place. And little by little, not so little, pretty quickly, I met the guy. He was having dinner, I think it was at a Reveal Richard here at a Chinese or some kind of an Asian restaurant, right?
Yeah, a Japanese restaurant.
A Japanese restaurant, and I looked at him, and, you know, and I said, you know, something, and you said something, and I said, you know, bring him to the house. And that was about 15 years later, and since then he has, like, in a sense, I know he's felt like he's led his own life, but essentially he's been with me. He's been with me for these 15 years, working with me in various capacities on different movies. If I would produce, he'd be the dialogue director, work with everybody on the dialogue. We don't know what that means.
He had the title,
and when I went over to Morocco, I was in the airport flying over there, and I called him from the airport, and I said, "What are you doing?" He says, "Nothing." He says, "What are you doing?" I said, "Well, I have to go over to Marrakesh. I'm doing this movie over there with Warren Beatty and Dustin Hoffman, and you want to come?" He says, "Yeah." So he comes over to Morocco with me, and I go to buy some rugs, and they want you to negotiate a lot, you know, and I don't want to do that. I don't want to do that. I see two rugs out of 87 million they have, two I like, and I send Richard over there, and I said, "These guys negotiate, so when they say they want this much money, I want you to throw yourself on the rug, on the floor, and grab them by their bottom of their coat and say, 'Please don't charge me so much money.'" And he did, and we got rugs at, like, great prices. And then you and the original rug guy went to the second to buy the second rug, right?
He came along with me, and he got down on the floor and grabbed him by the leg and went, please, give us a deal. And only because...
But the second guy didn't buy into it, right?
No, he was looking at him like, "You're embarrassing our whole culture. Why are you doing that?
Right.
Get up."
Right, yeah. Right. So the second guy didn't buy it, but the first guy, we're 6 minutes in. Oh, my, let me get to the point of this story. Anyway, let's reveal Rebecca Broussard, who is traveling. Rebecca Broussard, who's the star of Richard. Richard then became a director and a writer and made his own movie and everything. And Rebecca's a star. What is the name of this opus?
Point of Betrayal.
You know, also with Rod Taylor,
Dina Merrill.
Dina Merrill and Rebecca.
Right.
Rebecca, who is the lovely Rebecca, who's here. And you two are over in, what is it, Cannes. You're over in Cannes.
Yeah. Right.
And you're over there, and somehow you run into Prince Albert.
Prince Albert.
The son of Prince Rainier, Prince Albert.
Buddy Al.
Forgive me, I got to come to Fort Lee to get, you know, Prince Albert. And they meet Prince Albert, who is the son of Grace Kelly and Princess Grace and Prince Rainier, and somehow they're going to have a gathering at the castle, I guess, right?
Right. Well, I see him having dinner, and I go over and say, "Hi, how are you? This is my name, blah, blah, blah." And he says, "Are you going to be out at the race on Sunday, the big Formula One race?" And I said, "Well, you know, where do I go?"
Right.
So I write down all the instructions, and he gives me his, like, private
number. You ran into Prince Albert where?
At a restaurant. There was a Miramax party in Cannes, and it was at a restaurant called the Moulin de Majan.
Of course.
And so I went over there and schmoozed my way, and what I thought was, like, a really solid invitation for me and Rebecca to go and watch the race from Prince Rainier's apartments.
Uh-huh.
And so as we went there, I thought, well, I'll call at the last second and make sure everything's set. And his assistant, Bruno, said, "Well, you know, Mr. Martini, here's where you go, and the police escort will take you to the apartment. By the way, the invitation is for one. It's for Rebecca." So I thought, wait a minute, did I hear that right? Squeeze me? And so Rebecca gets on the phone and says, no, this is impossible. No, I'm... What did you say?
I told him, I said, "I feel very insecure about this, and I think there's a problem here. You know, I feel like I have to have Richard with me. You know, he's my dear friend and my assistant.
And your director and your
security guard.
And bodyguard.
So we tried everything, but he said, no, no, no. He can go to the reception, but he can't go come up to the apartment.
To the private quarters with Prince Rainier.
Right. So we go to
And they're absolutely right. I mean, why should you be with Prince Rainier? Look at you. Look at you. Let's widen this show. Look at this guy. I mean, this is ridiculous. A guy like this can't be with Prince Rainier. Go on. I'm sorry.
That's bad. I think what happened. So we showed up at the reception, you know, and I thought, well, we'll get a few minutes with, you know, Prince Rainier. But as we're walking up, here comes Prince Albert, and he sees me, and he comes over. I really have to apologize. It's a private thing. And I look at him and said, well, you know, you're going to miss out on a few laughs, buddy. Because we did fight a revolution, so you can call royalty buddy, apparently.
That's right. And how did he take that being called buddy?
He laughed and said, I bet you're right.
He laughed, but you were gone.
Yeah, but I was dismissed.
As he was being whisked away, right.
So then Bruno starts to take me to the reception. And I look at Bruno and say, where are you taking me? And Rebecca went upstairs, and my friends are waiting for me on their boat. And he says, well, you seem upset. I said, I'm not upset. I just thought what just happened here was kind of tacky. And it was like I'd slapped him with a glove. Suddenly,
tacky. Royalty doesn't like tacky.
No, there's no such thing.
He's not royalty. He works for royalty.
Right. It's as close as you can get to.
Right.
So I said, no. It's not that you're tacky. Just this whole thing is tacky. So I was dismissed summarily, and I went off to find my friends on their boat where they were going to watch the race, but they were gone. And there was a little guy in a dinghy, and he looks at me and says, you're late. Mr. Martini, quick, get in the boat.
Now, who are you with now?
By myself.
All right.
And she'd gone off into the apartments with the
Prince
whole...
Albert.
Yeah.
Right.
And eventually, I go across...
And you went off into the apartment. Why? You got a shot to be with Prince Rainier, and you said, what the heck?
I had to check it out. Yeah, I had to check it out.
And then how did you feel about leaving Richard on the dinghy?
I was pretty upset about it.
You were out.
Yeah.
You were out.
Oh, I knew I wouldn't laugh. You know, I knew if he wasn't there, I wouldn't laugh.
Right, because Prince Rainier, with all due respect, he's not known for, like, he's not Jackie Mason.
Right.
So this guy in the dinghy takes me across to this huge boat where my friends have gone, the Sheikh Al-Fazi's boat, which is the size of a football stadium. So it's the biggest boat in the harbor. So now I have a staff of 30 feeding me lobster and champagne, and I think, well, this isn't so bad. So what? I didn't get into the prince's apartment. But I look across, and I realize, well, there's the prince's apartment right across from us. So I pick up the Sheikh's, you know, mega binoculars where you can see a guy, you know, crosshairs from 50 yards. And I look across, and there's Rebecca up on a balcony.
Just
looking
bored.
At their look out of her mind. Royally bored.
Because Albert or Rainier, and they're not funny.
I guess they just weren't hanging with her or something.
Right.
So I borrow the Sheikh's cellular and say, do you mind? So I call, you know, the prince. Sheikh the prince, you know, direct line. So I call over there. Bruno answers the phone. I go, hey, how you doing, Bruno? It's Rich. And he says, what do you want? I said, well, can I talk to Rebecca, please? So he takes the phone out to her, and she gets these binoculars, and she's, where are you? And I said, just look for the biggest boat. Biggest boat in the harbor.
Now, you were on the Saruti boat, right?
No, the Sheikh Al-Fazi. The Saruti's had gone on.
Oh, my God, we're 11 minutes in. Go ahead.
Basically, so she's looking at me through the binoculars. Out comes Prince Albert, and he says, who are you talking to? And so she hands him the binoculars. I'm looking at him, you know, through my binoculars, and I see him, like, raise his hand like, oh, I thought I got rid of him. Prince wave. You know, and I give him a little princey wave, thinking, if I only could moan him, I really... No, I would never... Sorry, excuse me, Prince. But, you know, anyway. And so it was just very ironic to have that moment between us.
Now, did you see him through the binoculars?
I did see
And you two
him, yeah.
got together?
I was talking on the phone and looking at him through the binoculars when the prince came out and said, you know, what's going on here? What's...
Yeah, so because we kept your date on a dinghy, what are you looking at?
Right. So then as they wanted her to come to this big event afterwards, but she was like, I'm going to go with my friends. And as she left, the prince escorted her to the elevator.
Saying all these nice princely kind of things.
Like
and
what?
Then as I
Sounds
get on
sad.
The elevator, that the door's shutting and the prince says, and be sure to say hello to my friend Richard. The door closes.
Friend Richard. Get him! Speaking of, we have a whole royal. I don't want this guy. Anyway, we're going to go to a break. We want to wish Richard and Rebecca. What's the name of the movie?
Point of Betrayal.
It's not open. You can't see it at this moment, but it will come out. And they had a lot of fun there, and I've had a lot of fun with him, you know, so far, and a lot more to come. And we're going to be right back with Sally, Jesse, Raphael.